So here we are going to discuss about the today's topic is introduction to helminthology. What is the meaning of helminths? The helminths means that is worms. So under protozoa parasitology, we have discussed, we were discussed about the protozoans. So that is protozoans are amoeba, flagellates, the next sporozoans, those are present in protozoans. So protozoans are unicellular. So when you are going for the, when we are discussing about the helminths, so the meaning of helminths, so helminths are worms. So we can observe with our naked eye, we can observe. So that is the importance of the helminths. So helminths means worms. So here the helminths, the important characters of helminths are, here these are multicellular, multicellular in nature. So those are multicellular. So these are the parasites, multicellular in nature, multicellular, bilaterally symmetrical, elongated, flat or round bodies. So when we are observing any helminths, those are worms. Those are made up of it multicellular, bilaterally symmetrical. So elongated, those are flat. Some are elongated, symmetrical, those are flat and round bodies. So those are made up of it three germ layers, that is trophoblast and metazoa. So here this is the importance of the helminths. So helminth, what is meant by helminth? Helminth is a helminth means worms. So which is the parasite is a multicellular, bilaterally symmetrical, elongated and flat and round bodies. So here they are made up of three germ layers, that is trophoblastic metazoa. So here those are classified into two, that is a flat. So when we are observed, those are flat like structures, those are keep it under platy helminths. Round forms, round, so though flat, that is a flat or platy helminths. The next round form, so the helminths, that the helminths overall they have this classified into two types, that is flat worms, round worms. So the structure, when we observe the structure, that will be flat, those are keep it under platy helminths. Whereas some of the parasites, the helminths, they look like as worms, round cylindrical thread like, those are keep it under nematodes or nematihelminths. So remember these two classes, that is platyhelminths, nematihelminths. So platyhelminths are flat worms, round worms are nematihelminths. So here the platyhelminths, the platyhelminths are the platyhelminths, that is cystodes and trematodes. The class has, so we are having the two classes, platyhelminths, nematihelminths. So we are discussing about the platyhelminths. The platyhelminths are flat like, those are two types, that is cystoda and trematoda. So that is cystodes and trematodes. So here when we are observing the trematodes or cystodes, those are mostly flattened leaf like. So listen, trematodes are leaf like structures, whereas cystodes, when you observe any tape, so when you observe a measuring tape which is having the 1, 2, 3, 4 cut like structures, so that is a tape like structures will be there, that is other cystodes. The trematodes are leaf like structures, then the tape like on segmented. So when we observe these, both these, the cystodes are tape like, trematodes are leaf like, they are having the segmented. So mostly those are hermaphrodite or monoecious. So mostly these are monoecious. So means the both male and female organelles are present in one, that is a monoecious. So here the elementary canal is incomplete, or sometimes it may lack. So lacking of elementary canal, body cavity also absent. So most important characteristic feature of the platyhelminths, that is cystodes and trematodes, are those are monoecious. Those, the cystodes are tape-like structures. Trematodes, when you listen, So how you remember this trematodes? So every tree has leaves. So when you observe the trematodes means which is leaf-like structures. So leaf always having the tree always having the leaf. So that is the identification. Trematodes has a leaf-like structures. So those are segmented. So monoecious, those they lack of alimentary canal and body cavity. So these are absent. So this is the structures. So flat. So when you observe this, which is having the flat-like structures. So this is the flat form. So flat form. Then this is the cystodes. Cystodes has hooklets, suckers, neck. So that is head, neck, and strobella. So when you observe the cystodes, those are having the three structures. That is head. So it is having the head. This is neck. Next is scolex or head. So we can call it as scolex, neck, and strobella. Strobella has three forms. That is immature, mature, gravid form. So will be discussed in a cystodes class. But when you observe the flatty helminth, so those are flat-like structures. So this is the structures of flatty helminth. This is the liver fluke. So this is Laranacea. So this is the Laranacea structure. So next is a phylum nematode. Nemati helminths are nematodes. So nematoda, those are cylindrical, round, thread-like structures. So when you observe this, this is having the structure. This is round thread-like structures. Those are unsegmented bodies. So important thing of nematodes are dioecious. So dioecious means the sexes are separate. The male and female organelles are separated. They are having individual sexual organs. That is, alimentary canal is complete, body cavity is present. So 100% it will be opposite in flatty helminths. So flatty helminths doesn't have the alimentary canal and body cavity, but sexes also monoecious. Here it is a dioecious. So when you observe any nematode, the nematodes family are cylindrical, thread-like, round, oval form. That is paka. The next is this are having the alimentary canal, body cavity. This is a dioecious. So here it is that having the mouth, then pharynx, intestine, ovary, cuticle. This is anus. So next important thing is in nematodes are the males are always shorter. So males always shorter in length, the females are larger in length. So this is the main identification mark for nematodes. The male always shorter, female are larger. So when you observe this picture, the male, it is shorter, which is having the sperm duct, copulatory spicules, testes. So this will be the male. So here it is, when you observe the female, it is larger. So same, which is having the sexual organs. There is female sexual organs will be there. That is uterus, vulva, it is will be there, intestine, anus. So this is the female. So this is the main differentiation between the flatty helminths, nemati helminths. Major is the those are flatty helminths are flat-like structure. That is two class will be there. That is trematodes, nematodes. Trematodes, cystodes. Trematodes have leaf-like structure. Cystodes are that is a tape-like structures. Those are not having alimentary canal, body cavity. The sexes are those sexual particles are the monoecious. So here it is the dioecious. So you have to remember this. So this is the structures, the male and female worms. So different features, differences between the cystodes, trematodes, and nematodes. So the characters, these are the characters that is a shape of cystode. So you know that is tape like leaf-like, that is trematodes. So cylindrical or elongated. So characteristic differentiation between these three are cystode, tape-like structure, trematode, leaf-like structure, nematode, elongated, cylindrical. So body will be segmented. So cystodes, that is segmented, head, then next is neck, then strobella. So these will be observed with the segmented. So whereas the trematodes, so if you observe for the liver fluke or lung fluke, that doesn't show any segment, that is unsegmented. Nematode also unsegmented form. So So next is sexes will be, sexual organs will be monoecious, not separated in cystoids. Whereas the trematode also not separate except schistosoma species, schistosoma hematobium is there, that is dioecious. So here it is, both cystoids and trematodes are monoecious. So here the 100% nematodes are dioecious. So next, which contain suckers often with hooklets. So which contains suckers but doesn't have the hooklets. Next is both suckers and hooklets are absent. So nematode doesn't have the hooks and suckers and hooklets. So a well-developed buccal capsule are present. So here it is, the cystoids have the suckers, hooklets, everything will be there in cystoids. The trematodes only contains suckers but doesn't have the hooklets. Suckers and hooks are present in cystoids. Only suckers are present in trematodes. Whereas in nematodes, they doesn't have the suckers and hooklets, but doesn't have they have already developed the buccal capsule. So body cavity will be absent in both cystoids and trematodes, which is present in nematodes. So next is elementary canal. So here it is absent in cystoids. Next is, which is present in trematodes, but it is incomplete with no anus. So here it is also, the elementary canal is absent in both cystoids and trematodes. So most commonly there is a commonest features in cystoids and trematodes. So that's why they kept in platyhelminths. So nematodes, nematyhelminths, they are well developed elementary canal and which is complete. So here it is, when you observe any parasite, they are having the three morphological forms, that is adult worm, larval form and egg. So these three things will be there if you observe any parasite, cystoids, trematodes, nematodes. So if you observe a cystoid, larval form, so you know that it is in your intermediate, Cysticercus cellulose, Cysticercus bovis. So here it is, a Cysticercus is the larval form. So next larval form will be Cysticercoid, Coenarus, Coracidium. So these two are important, Cysticercus, Cysticercoid, Coracidium, Procercoid larva, Plerocercoid larva. The next is hydatid cyst. So remember this. So cystoids are having the C, which starts with C, that is Cysticercus, Cysticercoid, Coracidium, Procercoid, Plerocercoid and hydatid cyst. So these are the larval forms. If you observe any cystoids which are present, the parasite which are present in cystoids, they are having these larval forms. Next is the trematodes tree, which is having the leaf-like structures, that is Miracidium, Sporocyst, Radia, Sarcaria and Metasarcaria. Don't confuse. So each family, each worm has its larval form. Don't combine with others. So here it will be there, Miracidium. There is no Miracidium in cystoids, Sporocyst, Radia, Sarcaria and Metasarcaria. So next is nematodes. Nematodes are, those are cylindrical in shape. Those are dioecious. The larval form will be rhabdidiform larva, phylariform larva and microphylaria. So here it is the larval forms. So adult worms with larval forms. What are the larval forms of the worms? So these are the larval forms. So next, going through the platyhelminths. So the individually we discuss with the platyhelminths. What are there in platyhelminths? So platyhelminths are the cystoids and trematodes. Those two are, keep it under platyhelminths. So that is long, segmented and tape-like. They are flattened dorsally. So here it is, sizes vary from millimeter to several meters. So I will show you individual picture. So has head which is provided with suckers, that is slit-like or cup-like. So here it is the, this is the head, neck, strobila. So individually I will show you that. So sometimes which is having the hooklets. So here the three regions of the adult worm. So when you observe any cystoid, the cystoid has, that is a vary from, the size will be millimeter to meters, several meters, millimeter to several meter in length. They are having the structures. These three thrust structures will be there. That is head, neck, then strobila. Strobila has segments. Head we can call it as the other name is scolex. Scolex. So each individual worm is hermaphrodite. That is a male and female are separated. So body cavity is absent in cystodes. Trematodes it will be there, but it is incomplete. So elementary canal also absent. So excretory nervous system will be present. So reproductive system will be highly developed, incomplete, is complete in each segment. So reproductive system will be there in each segment of the cystodes. So here, according to the cystodes, reproductive organs are immature, mature, and gravid form. So this is the cystodes, the structures of the cystodes. So here it is the head, neck, strobila, scolex, neck, strobila. So this is the structure. What is the structure of head? So head consists of rostellum. Next, hooklets. Some may have the hooklets. That is hooklets. Next, suckers. So when you observe the head, head which is having the rostellum with hooklets or without hooklets, this is the scolex. Neck. So neck will be behind the scolex. So in between the strobila, neck will be there. So next, third part. So the third part will be having the strobila. The strobila has three structures: immature, mature, and gravid form. So here three forms will be there: immature, then immature will be developed as mature, then gravid form. So here when you observe the each segment, immature mature segment means which is having the vagina, genital pore, sperm count, ovary, so proglottid. So these will be present in the uterus. So this is the uterus also there. So this is the genital organelles of the cystodes. The cystode has the reproductive system. The reproductive organelles will be like this: ovary, vagina, genital pore, sperm duct, yolk gland. So these will be, these organelles will be present in the cystodes. So reproductive system will be developed. A male and female genital organ will be present. That is a monoecious. So male reproductive system consists of multiple testes. Vas deferens, vas efferentia with a thin convoluted tube, vas deferens will be there. So cystodes are, those are monoecious, means both male and female organs will be present. That is, female organs will be having the vagina, uti, ovary, oviduct, uterus, and small organs which will be called Mehalis gland will be there in uti. So this is the reproductive organs in male and females. Then they are having the eggs, the life cycle in pathogenesis and pathogens will be there. So this will be having the eggs also will be there. So this is the reproductive system: vas deferens, vas efferentia, uterus, testes, Mehalis gland. So here it is a Mehalis gland. So here it is the monoecious. So monoecious means both organelles are present in one worm. That is, both male and female will be there in one. So vas deferens, serous, genital atrium, vagina, ovary. So these are the reproductive organs, both male and female reproductive organs. Eggs. So cystodes or trematodes eggs will be like this. So this is the upper crown oval. Always when you observe any ovum, any cyst, so that is round oval and the operculum and knob will be there. So this is the cystodes of the tinea solium. Tinea solium, tinea saginata. This is the structure which is on the round oval. So here it is in the egg shell. Then hooklets will be there in egg. So this is the trematode egg. This is the cystodes. Round oval. When you observe the cystodes, that is the tinea solium, tinea saginata, round oval, then it is having the hooklets will be there. So this is the larval form of cyclophyllodin cystodes. Cysticercus, cysticercoid, Coenarus and Echinococcus. These are the larval forms. So individually will be discussed in each parasite morphology will be discussed individually there in the cystodes. So these are the structures. These are the larval forms, host. So everything will be there in cystodes. That is tinea solium, tinea saginata, Echinococcus, granulosus, H. nana. So these are the cystodes. So cystodes, adult worm will be having host, adult worm, So host will be there, different each parasite has its host, that is definitely host, intermediate host will be there. So larval cells, egg and larval cell, adult worm, larval, egg. So three forms will be there, whereas in protozoans, adult worm and eggs will be there. Trophozoites, sporozoites, that will be different. Here helminths are having three morphological forms, that is adult worm, larval form and eggs. So life cycles of cystodes. So any cystode, examples of the cystode is Tinea solium, Tinea saginata. So Tinea solium, Tinea saginata, the life cycle, it completes life cycle in one host. So that is, except that is H. nana and Diphyllobothron latum, two different hosts. So sorry, this cystodes will complete its life cycle in two different hosts, except that is H. nana and Diphyllobothron latum. So it needs more than two, that is H. nana and Diphyllobothron latum. Other than these two, each cystode completes its life cycle in two different hosts. So whereas the next is a trematodes. So trematodes completes in one definitive host and two intermediate hosts. So here they need three hosts, whereas cystodes, they need only two different hosts. So trematodes are completes it in one definitive host and two intermediate hosts. So the definitive host will be the fresh water. First intermediate host, the definitive host will be the man. So first intermediate host, second intermediate host. So first intermediate host will be the fresh water snail or molluscan bodies. So these are acting as a first intermediate host. So this fresh water and snail, which is taken by the fish or crab, so these are acting as a second intermediate host. So here the person who has taken the contaminated water or food, they have released the fecal sample. So here it is the man is the definitive host. So next, the released fecal sample will be enters into the water, fresh water, or which is taken by the snail or molluscan body, that is will be acting as an intermediate host. Second intermediate host will be the fish or crab. So the snails, which is taken by the fish or crab, so that is acting as a second intermediate host. This is about the trematodes. Cystodes completes life cycle in two different hosts, whereas trematodes, listen this, cystodes only two hosts, whereas a trematodes leaf has many leaves, a tree has many leaves, like that. You remember this, the trematodes has three hosts, one definitive, two intermediate host. The nematodes are having only one host. The man is the most commonest host for nematodes, except Filarial and Dracunculus. Some exceptions is there for nematodes, the most commonly one. Listen, nematodes one, trematodes three, cystodes two, trematodes three, one, two, three. So nematodes one host, trematodes, cystodes two host, trematodes three, one, two, three, one for nematode, two for cystodes, three for trematodes. P is there, that indicates three hosts. Remember this, there is no confusion in this host. There is a more confusion in host, that is when you are discussing with cystodes, trematodes, nematodes. So remember this, nematodes one host, cystodes two, trematodes three. So three hosts will be there. This is the easy way for remembering this hosts. So pathogenicity. So most commonest pathogenicity, according to their habitats, they will cause the infection. So helminths. So due to the helminths, by direct damage by the host. So helminths, if the body resistance is lower, they may damage the host immune response. Host the tissue will be damaged. So here it is the allergic response of the host to the helminths. So malnutrition of the host. So most commonly, according to their habitats, they will cause the infection. So here the host immunity is less. Host immune response, host immunity will be, that will be damages the immune system. So this is all about the introduction to helminths. So here it is the helminths introduction, that is cystodes, trematodes, nematodes. These three will be there. Next, individually, we'll discuss with the cystodes. So three, I was explained about the three things, that is trematodes, nematodes, cystodes. So cystodes and Trematodes are platyhelminths. The nematelminths are nematodes. Cystodes. So cystodes. Cystodes. What are there in cystodes? The cystodes are again they are having the two orders. That is pseudophyllidian, cyclophyllidian. So first we'll discuss with the cystode family. So we'll complete with their life cycle, pathogenesis, lab diagnosis, that is with cystodes. So after completion of the cystodes, I will start with trematodes. Next is nematodes, only three families. So order first is pseudophyllidae. So pseudophyllidae, we are having the adult one, that is in man, that is diphyllobothrum latum. So next is cyclophyllidae. Pseudophyllidian, cyclophyllidian. Two orders will be there in cystodes family. That is Actinia solium, Actinia saginata, Hymenolepis nana. So short name is H. nana. So for our exam, most commonly asking question is, most commonest question is Actinia solium, Actinia saginata. So expected short notes questions. Actinia solium, Actinia saginata. For very short notes, they may ask H. nana. So diphyllobothrum latum also. Very rare times they may ask. So first we'll start with the pseudophyllidian tapeworms. So before this, so what are the worms present in cystodes? That is Actinia solium, Actinia saginata, Hymenolepis nana, three, and first one is the diphyllobothrum latum. Only four parasites are there in cystodes for our exam. So next, so these are the cystodes. So trematodes. So trematode, what are the trematodes? Important trematodes, liver fluke. The liver fluke is Fasciola hepatica. Then next, liver fluke. Then next, lung fluke, Paragonimus westermani. So liver fluke, lung fluke. So these are there, so many are there, but important is the liver fluke, lung fluke. So this is the trematodes. So next is next thing is, that is nematodes. So nematodes family, cylindrical, round, oval form, that is that is Ascaris lumbricoides, round worm. Next, Echinococcus granulosus. The name, scientific name, Echinococcus granulosus, common name is hookworm, round worm, hookworm. Next is redworm, pinworm, seedworm. It will be there. That is Trichinella. So many parasites are there. First, Tinea, that is Ascaris lumbricoides, Ascaris lumbricoides, Echinococcus granulosus, microfilarial larva, microfilarium form. That is filarial larva. That is Pokeraria branchophyta. So individually, we'll discuss there in nematodes family. So up to this, I have finished the introduction to helminths. So the helminths are trematodes, nematodes, and cystodes.